namely that antidepressants often do not do what they promise and are in fact causing harm to many.
Dr. Steve Hoetze is suing over Obamacare's employer mandate.
It's time for a wellness revolution. Brought to you by Hoetze Health and Wellness Center. Honest discussion on maintaining health and wellness naturally to enjoy a better quality of life.
He's the doctor fighting to let you keep your doctor.
Now, Dr. Stephen Hoetze.
Welcome to Dr. Hoetze's Wellness Revolution. I'm Stacey Banfield here with Dr. Stephen Hoetze, who is the founder of the Hoetze Health and Wellness Center. And if you ever want to download any of our podcasts, you can always go to hoetzepodcast.com. That's H-O-T-Z-E podcast.com. We always have a lot of really great content and information. And speaking of great content and information, this is going to disturb a few people, including myself, because I love salmon, like so many people out there. And we always hear that salmon is just one of those foods that you just have to get into your diet. However, some people wonder, you know, should I pay more or should I pay attention to whether it's wild or farm-raised? Well, Dr. Hoetze has the questions today, and the answers are kind of disturbing but very important. So pay attention, y'all. Good information right ahead.
Thank you, Stacey, and thank each one for joining us here today. Remember, I believe you need a doctor and a staff of professionals to coach you onto a path of health and wellness naturally so that as you mature, you have an enjoyable quality of life without having to resort to pharmaceutical drugs.
Absolutely.
We'd like to bring you up to date on little tidbits about health during our podcast. And today, I decided we would talk about salmon. Now, I love salmon. So do you.
Love it, yes.
And as a matter of fact,
big fan.
I think 2 weeks ago, 6 out of 7 days, I had salmon every night. You know, went out to eat. I had it at Carrabba's, had it at Capital Grill, had it over at some other restaurant, just enjoy salmon. Mm-hmm. And my wife will bring some salmon home from Whole Foods, too, and we'll have it there. So we're big salmon. And the reason we are is because we eat a ketogenic-based diet. That means we focus on good, healthy oils, good fats, like eggs and butter and fish oil, olives, avocados, guacamole, which is avocados deluxe. And, you know, nuts and those sort of things have a lot of good healthy oils in our diet. And then a lot of green vegetables, and we minimize our meat. We may have 4 ounces of meat a day. And usually when we eat meat, mm-hmm. most commonly it's fish. Most common fish we eat is salmon. So, mm-hmm. and because it's healthy and it's got good fish oils in it, and then we eliminate the simple carbs, the sugar and the pizza, pasta, breads, and cereals and all that to keep our inflammatory level down in our body. And so this ketogenic eating program has been very helpful, and it's a lot of mm-hmm. the meat in it is fish-based, really. You can eat any meat on it you want to. You only need to eat about 4 ounces a day max. But so salmon, I came across a recent article on salmon about farm-fed salmon. And I ask sometimes at the other night it was a Capital Grill, and I asked Jay, our waiter, I said, Jay, Is this farm fed salmon, or is it you coming out of the ocean?
And what was the answer?
I'm saying, you know, kind of double talk me a little bit, but I think it's probably farm fed, I bet. But I didn't really think much about it. I just know farm fed fish aren't going to be as good because I knew they do some additives. But let me just tell you what they add to these fish. They put them in huge nets in the ocean, okay? They're in nets, and they put them in, and they overpopulate. They put literally millions of these fish in these nets, and so it'd be like going to a ranch in Texas and seeing a herd of cattle just all congregated together, you know, thousands of them, rather than spread out on the field, they're all together, and you know that's not healthy for them. And so to keep them from getting various diseases, and remember, fishes are animals, and all animals can acquire various diseases, and to prevent these diseases, they put pesticides and antibiotics into the water to feed the fish, and they have dry pellets that they feed them. So they're not eating their normal food. They're eating these dried pellets, which contain dioxins and polychlorophenols and other toxic pollutants in the water, some petrochemical-type products. And they get this into their system, and the PCBs that are concentrated in the farm salmon are 8 times higher than you see in the wild salmon, so they have a lot of dangerous chemicals in their body. Interestingly enough, nutritionally, good oils are produced by fish. And there's two particular oils that are important for our health, omega-3 fatty acids and omega-6. But in farm-fed fish, particularly the salmon, the omega-6 is 5.5 times more than is produced in the wild. And that's because they feed them a lot of fat, and these various foods that they feed them aren't natural. They're trying to, just like they do at a feed farm for cattle, they're trying to fatten them up because they get paid by the pound.
And we just don't think of that with fish. It's
right.
It's just a funny concept.
So in these fish farms, these fish are plagued with various diseases, and yet they're still taken out, caught, slaughtered, and sent to the market. So sick fish are sent to the market and sold in the various stores. So that made me think, maybe the best thing to do, if I like salmon so much, is to go to a person or store that conveys healthy, natural salmon. And this would be wild sockeye salmon. And you can get that. I know at Whole Foods has natural salmon that's caught offshore. And that's going to be the best thing that you can possibly do. If you're going to eat salmon or really any fish, make sure it's caught in the wild. Then you will not be exposed to near. Doesn't mean that all these fish in the wild don't have chemicals, because we dump all the chemicals in the whole world get dumped into the ocean. So we know all fish have some kind of mercury level, and they all have some kind of toxins in them, just like we do. But the ones that are farm-fed have dramatically higher levels of these harmful chemical products and pesticides that are really, the cancer-causing. Mm-hmm. And so we don't want to be putting those in our body. So that's just a little tip. If you're going to eat salmon or you're going to eat fish, make sure they're caught in the wild.
Absolutely. And it sounds like, Dr. Hotze, that, it's actually just as bad as eating junk food, or you're better off not having it at all. I mean, if you're going to don't have salmon at all, if you're just going to have farm raised, you definitely want to make the right choice.
And it's the same thing. And it's hard to get away from. Where can you go? If you go out to dinner, you want to eat. You have to eat pretty much what they've got there. And who knows, and you know that these are going to be farm-fed because that's just the way they supply, just like the cattle are all fed in the, when they take them for sale, they pump them full of antibiotics, they pump them full of hormones trying to gain weight on them so they can sell them. And they put their pesticides in the cattle. And so that's why it's always best, if you can, to get grain-fed beef. That's best, because they're not going to have all these additional chemicals in their bodies. So the long and the short of it, eat animals from the wild. You'll be better off. So maybe we ought to do more deer hunting and things like that, or hunt for elk or moose. They're all around.
That's right.
We got plenty of deer in Texas.
We sure do.
Anyway, eat healthy, eat wild.
That's right. Remember what Dr. Hotze says, everybody needs a health coach, and we would love to be able to serve you. You can always call 281-698-8698 for a free health consultation. That's 281-698-8698. Thank you so much for joining us here today at Dr. Hotze's Wellness Revolution.
Information provided on this radio program is neither intended nor implied to be a substitute for professional medical advice and is not intended to replace the services of a physician, nor does it constitute a doctor-patient relationship. You should not use information from this radio program to diagnose or treat a health problem or disease without consulting with a qualified healthcare provider. If you have or suspect you have an urgent medical problem, promptly contact a professional healthcare provider or call 911. Dr. Hotze's Wellness Revolution radio program advises you to always seek the advice of a physician or other qualified health provider prior to starting any new treatment or with any questions you may have regarding a medical condition. Any application of the recommendations from this radio program is at the listener's discretion.